I'm Elaine, the Ninja Life Coach, and today we're going to talk about Abraham. You know, Abraham is often called by evangelical Christians the father of the faithful, and there is a good reason why. The reason why is because when God told Abraham to do something, Abraham, he did it. He didn't hesitate. He didn't fiddle around about it. He did it. He went. When God said go, Abraham went. You know, in Hebrews, the 11th chapter, it says that God, I think it's the 6th verse, it talks about God told Abraham to go and Abraham went even though he didn't know where he was going. You know, I have found in my relationship with God that a lot of times God will tell me something and it'll just be a little something. It won't be this big monumentous something. It'll be something small. It'll be something tiny. And I will take that step, and then after I've taken that step, I will be given the next step. I have seldom had God speak to me in ways like, go out your front door, go thou up onto a mountain, there you shall find a cave, and in that cave you will find a hermit. That hermit will give you a tablet with the words written on it, here is $200,000, take thou this bag, go spend wisely. But that's never happened to me. If that's happened to you, well, thank God for it, but that's never happened to me. God usually speaks to me in little incremental bites at a time, and the reason why is because I'm rather stupid. You know, I have to take little small steps because I don't gallop at a real quick pace anymore. I am getting older. I've gotten wiser. I've gotten a little bit more hesitant about just jumping off the cliff, which is good in some ways, and it's not so good in other ways. So I want to encourage you today that if God has laid something on your heart and he has told you something to do, be like Abraham. Go do it. Don't try to overthink it. Don't try to overpray it. Don't try to overemphasize it. Just go do it. Take that one small step. Honestly, what do you have to lose by taking one small step? It could be something as simple as going and talking to your neighbor about the gospel. It could be something just as simple as checking into making a business plan. It could be something as simple as balancing your checkbook. It could be something just as simple as taking a meal to someone who's sick. Something simple. Making out a business plan doesn't mean that you have to leap off and go in $10 million in debt and open a business tomorrow. That doesn't mean that. That doesn't mean anything like that. That just means I am formulating a plan and I will move forward when I'm given the rest of my plan. And that is all that means. Be prepared for when God gives you a little word, prepare it, nurture it. Be like Abraham. When God tells you to go, you go, brothers and sisters, because God is on our side if we are on his side and we're looking to do his will for our life. I'm going to show you my little dog, Trixie. Here she is. She has been trying to get on my lap during this entire video, so I figured I'd just get her up here and let her see you guys. She's a loving little thing, and she loves her mama. But you know, when I tell Trixie to go and do something, she doesn't always do it. She's like us. She's not always obedient to her master. Even though she's a good dog, she is sometimes disobedient, and we are too. You know, the Word of God talks about in the Old Testament when Samuel says to King Saul, obedience is better than sacrifice, because Saul had been disobedient to what God had told him to do, and he made a sacrifice, an Old Testament type sacrifice to God instead. And Samuel, the priest, said, you know, that's all well and good, but, you know, obedience is what God wants. It's better than that sacrifice. So what is God laying on your heart today for you to do? What's he saying? Go do. Whatever it is, pray about it, read your Bible about it, get wise counsel about it, and move with it. This is a new year. Hope you guys have a wonderful day. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. God bless. Maranatha.